I don't think it's a glitch. I think it's something part of the dreadline. Like control.
I'll be able to keep closing. But they die a bunch. Nerd. Fucking piece of shit orb keep closing on me, you bitch.
Kate, what's our next move?
I don't know. Tell me.
We need that transmat zone up and running. There's a massive hull breach near your position. That'll be your best bet.
Down.
Nobody ever had a dream around here, but I don't really mind that it's getting to me. Nobody ever pulls the scene around here, but I don't really mind that it's getting to me. I've got this energy beneath my feet, like That's pretty badass, though, that I've managed to get a couple of exotic guns, but I'm really excited I got the strike gauntlets from a Titan. She's going to be handed some pretty nice stuff when she turns level 40. And I got some Warlock exotic gauntlet, the ones exotics for her, too, so when she turns 40. She'll get some new guns and some new gear, and probably more by the time I actually play them and get them to 40.
What gauntlet?
I got the ones you bought, the exotic sensor head.
Our ship is in.
I bought them like the day one. I just put them in my vault for.
So the ones I'm currently wearing.
Yeah.
Yeah, I love these things.
You shall not pass. I love curse thralls.
I love my lightning. I love how much my lightning changes.
That's one of my favorite spells in every game, is chain lightning. It's one of I like the arc lightning grenade for the hunter.
Yeah, I also put on a perk where it doubles my chaining capability.
Nice.
You landed a guardian on the dreadnought without authorization?
No, yes. He landed fucking the GTA, bitch. That's what we do. We go in first, make sure it's safe for the rest of the guardians. Oh look, we got ourselves a little tanky wanky.
Yeah, and if you see our ship up there, our ship just flew in and then flew away.
Where'd you die?
I died up here.
How'd you die up there?
I was paying attention to my ship and
Oh dude, I made it all the way up to the top one.
I'll bring down some ammo crates from the ship.
Oh shit! Oh my god, I'm still climbing
it. God damn it! I was hiding, and he shot me again. God damn it. I'm inside now. I'm at the inside part of it. Run.
Okay.
I'm not gonna fit up there anymore. I don't feel like it's safe.
I like the ribs over here where you can see them like broken the hull rigging. Oh shit, Billy.
Mm-hmm.
That was a hard lane. Yeah, I just love walking around quietly on the dreadnought. I like that there's no sparrows on it, so you don't see like people zooming past everything. You have to boots on the ground, bitch.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, let's see what we got here. I'll start with that bitch. Oh, totally overshot my binding. Thank you very much. Damn, each one of these blows up for 7,000.
Damn.
And it shoots out like, and it keeps burning. Oh, that's my grenade. Yeah, that one blew up a little less. First one seemed to be a little more. I think my binding. two purples up there. And my sword's full. I was like, where's the tank? I totally didn't see it over there. I love when these the shielders put their shield up and the fucking bombs are on the inside of them. They're like, no.
Yeah.
Like they close the shield on their own face with the bombs right there. We got an ogre. Why doesn't the ogre and the tank fight? I really hate that they both stop to fight us. They really don't think it would be that way.
No, look at this. The ogre just killed the tank.
Oh, did it?
The ogre just killed the tank.
Nice. Yeah. Yeah, thanks, ogre. You're dead now. Get the fuck out of here. Yeah, I turned a corner, but I couldn't tell if it was you or the ogre. That was great.
Did you, Mr. Ogre? Now you're gonna die.
Thanks, Ogre. Man, I love when the hive does over first.
Everyone loves a bad idea when it works. Now,
five more infusions.
I said it's 15 more towards my new Zodiac.
I just, you know, all the legendary gear I might need, I keep getting from, like, leveling up Dead Orbit or Vanguard, and I'm, you know, right now, like, infusing the few exotics I know I'm not going to get rid of, and a few legendaries I don't want to get rid of. I mean, I've taken some 260s to 295s just to keep them up with me, and hoods. Everyone's, like, rushing to get a year two, but I just went out and found 2 year two new exotics, so why bother getting my old ones up right away? Yeah. I mean, you know. Let's, let's go hunt Surdoc really quick. By the time we get back, Lando will be on, and we'll be able to do some of the tougher stuff. I think you and me could hunt this fool by ourselves. No problem. Give him a shot to get in on the Nightfall.
Alright, I'll be back real fast. I'm gonna go roll myself a smoke.
You're tuned in to, of course, me, myself, and I, watching Batman and myself just grind it out. We're getting ready for the raid this week. We want to jump in tomorrow, but the sad part is school's in session right now. Whether we've got people we play with in college, high school, junior high, working. So, you know, Monday through Friday has become really not as popular for me doing the strike, or sorry, the raid. I kind of wait and do it on Saturday. Problem is, you know, because it's just everyone's home. So we're just going to see where it goes. And for today, I've got really important Crucible and questing a few quests and Nightfalls and then just grinding strikes. And then really talking about and picking who wants to go with the raid. Like I said, the big thing with raids, it to me isn't really your toughness or light and skill level, because those can be ground up and polished off. When we go into a raid, one of the big things is being able to commit to the time in real world time. Because we've had people be like, oh, I want to go on the raid, I want to go on the raid in 20 minutes. And they're like, okay, I got to go to my aunt's house. Can you guys stop and pick it up tomorrow? You know, like, I'm like, you know, shit like that. So just, you know, we take it really seriously. There's nothing worse than going into a long, arduous adventure and then having people argue amongst themselves, you know, bitch and moan. You know, it's us against them. And I tend to go into the Vogue and Crota and would have a lot of people be more against each other. And we even quit playing in the raids for that reason for a while.
Alrighty.
You know, I hear too many people say they're going to go roll themselves a smoke.
I did.
That's cool. You know, I've noticed a lot more people have stopped taking their sparrows on Earth and stuff all the time. Like, you still see people doing
it. Yeah, it's
more fun. I think it's fun to drive them, but in certain spots. Like, I love driving them on, you know, Mars and Venus in certain areas because I love cutting and turning and juking and doing shit like that. I'm trying to get my dead orbit up so I can, hopefully they'll give me a helmet or Vanguard. I just want one. Have you seen the Scion Flare's Hunter cloak?
Yeah, that's really cool.
Yeah, I was just thinking, I wish we had a hologram cloak like everyone else. You're listening to 7 Mary 3 on GGO.
Yeah, I love it how you make orbs with double kills.
With this gun, yeah. And you make one orb per two, so if you get like four with one. What's really beautiful about this, and that, you know, people that know my Hunter is, you know, I played my Hunter up until Dark Below came out. I just had my Hunter. I never made my other two characters. And his first, when he was level 16, I opened up a legendary that gave me Plan C. Or no, sorry, I was like level 20 at the time. Like, I peaked out. And, so Plan C was my first exotic, and it's still one of my favorites. But the fusion rifle, I was a heavy fusion rifler. Oh, nice. And it's kind of funny that, I got Jade Rabbit first, but, you know, I kind of like my dead orbit gun a little more. So it's kind of perfect. I got my 295 dead orbit, and I got a 295 fusion rifle. And I think I love it because it shoots out like firecrackers or like fireworks. They sound like they pop, they're like fireworks. And it makes this weird sound when I shoot it. It's just hard to hear on the show. But it literally sounds like it goes... It's so fucked up. I like how they give the exotics a little more personality. Like, not just a special skill. They give them, like, unique looks. Yeah, no, that's good. Now, I don't know, is there another new exotic fusion rifle?
I'm not 100% sure. I only know of the Hereafter.
Yeah, so it doesn't do a lot of impact on the first sometimes. You know, you see like 10s and 11s when it hits you. Just depends on what you are, how successful.
Oh, hey, look at that, taking forces.
Nice. We need to go one over though, not here. But we can still do this one. Now, these are all considered majors. I was thinking about what you said about how any Ultra counts. So I was trying to think of what have Ultras. Like, Poe 28, you fight an Ultra then.
Yeah, that's an Ultra at the end. Any boss is an Ultra.
You could get two exotics in one if you did that. I have a key, and I have a three of coins. So I could get a drop engram and one from the thing.
Yeah.
Nice. Pay me that. That's what I like to see.
Pay me those dry mugs.
I haven't done Nightfall yet, but I have a fire team pretty much spoken for it. Although I end up doing them like two or three times a week. I'm glad I'm not managing all three characters right now. Oh my god. I'm glad that I do this with the DLC. That I do one for a month, one for a month, and one for a month. Usually two every time I get some goodies with my Hunters and my other characters, so as soon as they come on, they go up even faster.
Thank you for that blue candy, good sir.
I got fucking low ends over here.